The word of the week is
peace.
The definition of peace is freedom from disturbance. It can also be referred to as tranquility. The reason for peace being our word of the week is because Saturday, 21st September 2019 is International Day of Peace, also known as World Peace Day.
World Peace Day was first celebrated in 1981, and since then, each year on the 21st of September, the world comes together to devote a day to strengthen their ideals of peace, both within and among all nations and people. In this video, we will learn more about the International Day of Peace.
There needs to be one day, a universal day, that is all people all around the world just focus on peace.
When I get older, I will be stronger. They'll call me freedom, just like a waving flag.
The International Day of Peace becomes a global observation. It's observed around the world in every country. And everyone on the planet knows about it and observes it in some way.
When I get older, I will be stronger. They'll call me freedom, just like a waving flag.
Day of Peace is an opportunity for animals and animals to observe a day of peace together.
In 1981, the UN established, by a unanimous resolution of all member nations, the International Day of Peace.
When we'll be free, so we patiently wait for that fateful day. It's not far away, but for now we say.
Important to our lives that each year we dedicate an international award to peace and a special peacemaker. This is called the Nobel Peace Prize. Some famous winners of this prize include Barack Obama, Malala, and even groups of people like the European Union.
Mr. Steele, what does peace mean to you?
Peace to me is almost a feeling of calm and tranquility. I think it's being free from arguments and disagreements, free from people falling out and fighting. It always reminds me of going to Mass, actually, because in Mass we offer each other a sign of peace as a way of showing that we're together and that we love each other. So peace to me is all of those things.
Mr. Steele, when are you at peace?
I would say I'm most at peace when I'm on holiday. Visiting different places or relaxing in the sunshine. When I see other people happy, so my friends and my family and the children here in school, that makes me feel at peace. And I would say probably when I'm in my garden, because I love gardening, so that makes me feel very calm and relaxed as well and peaceful.
Christopher, what does peace mean to you?
Peace means to me when, like, someone has a fight, and then someone stops them, and then it brings the two people peace.
Christopher, how do you feel when you're at peace?
I feel relaxed, and it's very soothing.
Beatrix, what does peace mean to you?
Peace means that you can have quiet time, and you can think about all the good things.
Beatrix, have you ever struggled to be at peace with someone?
I struggled to be at peace with someone because I had an argument together and I thought it was hard to get back together.
Miss Eamon, what does peace mean to you?
Well, Lucy, to me, peace means a time of calm and quiet where you have no arguments or no disruptions at all in your mind, just a time to think and be calm.
Miss Seaman, have you ever struggled to be at peace with someone?
I have actually, Lucy. I've struggled to be at peace with myself sometimes. When I've done something wrong and I felt really guilty or not done something that I should have done, then I've struggled to be at peace with myself. And I found it really important to think about how God forgives us and how God loves us and his love's unconditional. And that's helped me then to be at peace with myself.
Faye, how do you feel when you're at peace?
I feel safe and secure.
We can experience many different types of peace. There's inner peace, where we are calm and reflective. There's peace between each other, where we make and keep friends, resolve arguments, and build bridges.
There is peace in the community, where we can find common ground between people and respect any differences. And there is peace in the world, where wars are ended and countries talk instead of fight.
Christians believe that the most important type of peace is peace with God. This can be through asking for forgiveness and from God and making a new start. This is where it all must start for true peace to be found, both inside ourselves and between each other.
In the Bible, there are many examples of peace. These can be examples of Jesus teaching us about peace or examples of God telling us that we should live our lives peacefully. For example, in Matthew 5 verse 9 it says, "Happy are those who work in peace, for the Lord will call them his children."
John chapter 14 verses 27 tells us, "Peace is what I leave with you. It is my own peace that I give you. I do not give as the world does. Do not be worried or upset, do not be afraid."
In Philippians chapter 4 verse 7, we hear that God's peace, which is far from beyond human understanding, will keep your hearts and minds safe.
And in John chapter 15 verses 11 to 12, it says, "I have told you this so that my joy may be in you and that your joy may be complete. My commandment is this, love one another just as I am with you."
The specific piece of scripture we would like you to focus on in class this week is 1 Peter chapter 3 verse 10 to 12.
Scripture linked to the word. We can see from that short piece of scripture that if we are peaceful in our lives, help at peace with others, and help others find peace themselves, we will live happiness in our lives. If we link this piece of scripture to the other pieces we have spoken about earlier, we can see that the message in all of them is that we should always live in peace and be peaceful with those around us.
School's mission statement is trusting in God creating tomorrow, helping today. If we have a trust in God that he will help us to live peacefully and be at peace with others, we will be able to help today as we will support the world to be peaceful, and by doing this we will be creating a better tomorrow, as the future generations will see the good that living in peace does. God will always be with us to help us find peace and be peacemakers in the world.
Whenever we are struggling to find peace, we know that God will be there to support us and help us through the difficult times.
There are many different signs of symbols of peace. These are just some examples of symbols of peace. A dove, an olive branch, a cross, a flaming torch, the Olympic rings, and a CND badge. In the wider world, a symbol of peace could be a peace treaty being signed, weapons being laid down, enemies shaking hands, two hostile flags flying together, or a calm lake scene.
During Mass, we share peace with each other by shaking hands and saying, "Peace be with you." The symbol of peace that we'll focus on today in our response is the dove.
We would like you to pray the Flying Dove Peace Prayer. You will need a shawl, a dove shape, a small rectangular piece of paper, sellotape and pencils.
Write a prayer for people who need God's peace on the dove.
Wrap the rectangle of paper around the straw, not too tightly, and then fold the top of the paper over. Make sure there is a small gap between the fold in the paper and top of the straw. On the other side of the dove, sellotape down the paper fold with the straw inside. Then turn the dove the right way around, aim it and then blow through the straw. Watch your peace dove fly as a symbol of giving the prayers to God and helping others find peace.
Your mission this week is to live peacefully with those around you and encourage peace between all people.